All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run you through the whole song. Really nice and slow, so you can just check out all the finger patterns, all the shapes I'm using, okay? The song is in DADGAD, yeah? DADGAD. Ignore these capos, okay? Don't worry about them. The guitar is tuned to DADGAD. Song's got, I'd say, four parts really. It's got the intro, it's got this sort of double stop sliding riff comes up the neck, and then it's got a couple of bass riffs, okay, and that's about it. It's pretty straightforward tune. So let me run you through, and I'll make a few comments. I'll just point out a few things that might be useful to you, okay? Right, the intro, here we go. Sort of hammer-ons and pull-offs, like a, same on here. I hope that's slow enough. Hope you got that. I'll tell you one thing that would be great if you're playing with a mate and you're doing this intro, and if you came up with a bit of a harmony part for it, you know, you can put that same riff. Right? You know, you're playing that together, that sound really mint. Right, next riff. You sort of end on this. I want you to change your finger, yeah? Come, use your second finger, just switch. You'll be ready for the next shape. So end on that, switch finger. I'm gonna drop into this double stop. Are you ready? Here we go. Just take these four strings, the mid and high strings. Yeah, leave the bass out. Here we go. Open this finger up, and then that's the tune. A couple of things that I found this one a bit hard to sort of get down with this sliding around, but a couple of things that help. This position, just sort of lock it, yeah, just sort of almost get like a bit of a claw, get a bit of tension in it and lock the shape. Don't have it all loose, so when you move it around it just falls out of shape. Just lock that position, and it will help you shift around. And another thing, try and visually lock onto where you're going next, where your fingers are traveling to next, yeah? Just visually see the next fret, and it will help you with a bit of accuracy when you slide it around. Obviously you're going to strum this one, yeah, you're going to strum this one. Yeah. Enough of that one. Right, the you got your first sort of bass one. It's gonna go from like a D to a C, you know, that sort of C shape, to a G, and that's it. D, C, G. Okay. So let's run through it slowly. After the double stop one, which is just on the higher strings, when you drop that bass in, that sounds pretty heavy. I think it sounds pretty good. And last bass part is good. It's just going to go from a D to C, G, and then you got your F. Okay, let's see what's going on there. So you got practicing it, I just try picking out the individual notes. Get the idea. That's about it. That's the whole tune. Beautiful, beautiful tune this. I'll tell you what you want to do. Go onto YouTube and just type in straight beat 70 BPM. Okay? It's a drum track. This guy's got some amazing drum tracks. I'm always playing along. So just whack that on and play along. I hope that was useful to you.